At last, the film you thought you'd never have to see. The great rock and roll swindle. The staggering story of the punk group that wrung the neck of rock and roll. Sex Pistols, a kamikaze gang of cat burglars and child prostitutes, they peddled bondage whips and chains to the children of Britain. Business to ransom and swindle the £1 million in the process. Sex Pistols, they stuck a safety pin through Her Majesty's nose and turned the national press into an occupied zone. A great train robber into the top 10 and destroyed the myths of their own success. Yes, the kids are f***ed up. See the film that incriminates its audience. The Great Rock and Roll Swindle, starring Sid Vicious, the John Travolta of punk. If everyone has 50 minutes of stardom in them, Sid's watch was running fast. Now his ambition is to haunt the music business. Steve Jones, tea leaf, window cleaner and walking hairdo. The only notes that mattered to Jones were the ones that came in wads.
I was only in it for the birds after the show.
Paul Cook, an ugly, acrobatic punk from London's Shepherd's Bush. He called the Queen a moron.
Come on, blow waves. Unzip his trousers. Let's see what his Sex Pistol is all about.
Johnny Rotten. Was he really a hunchback antichrist with green teeth, or just another juvenile Bill Grundy serving time on Virgin Records? Ronnie Biggs, legendary mastermind behind the great train robbery.
Well, you will ask the famous question, where's all the money?
He never sang for Scotland Yard, but he burst his lungs for the Sex Pistols. Martin Bormann, Hitler's deputy, was just another starving Nazi on the run until he joined the Sex Pistols. Now he's receiving royalties from Virgin Records. Mary Millington, fully cantilevered and gorgeous. She thought she'd tried everything until she met the Sex Pistols. Malcolm McLaren, a modern-day Fagin, conjuring cash from chaos. He was the architect of this fabulous ruin. Look on his works, ye mighty, and despair.
Would you say that punk rock is finally dead?
That's the most laughable question I've heard this year. Who killed Bambi?
No one is innocent, but some are more guilty than others. Are you part of the great rock and roll swindle? Risk seeing it and find out.